is from the Hebrew word aman, which is the word for faith. When it says Abraham believed in the Lord and the Lord counted it him for righteousness in Genesis 15, right? And when it says that, Abraham believed, the word there's aman, where you get the word amen. And the word is left, the word is literally transliterated later on into Latin, into English. Amen remains, is the most popular word. You know, God doesn't have the promise, because God's word alone is enough. But when God promises, there's a double ironclad guarantee. So all the promises of God is yes. Amen. All Old Testament, New Testament, is all there for you. But how do you make it yours? How do you make what God promised yours? When you say amen, you are saying, be done to me according to your word. There's no effort on my part. It's all in your promise. Be it unto me. In other words, when you say be it unto me, means what? It's not my efforts, it is your promise. All the promises of God has been fulfilled in Christ. In Christ and Christ alone. We say what? Amen. Amen. If you just keep quiet, nothing will happen. By His stripes, His Son's stripes, you are healed. That's it. I know amen can become a cliche, I know that. But once we have a revelation of it, let's say it, you know, with a meat, with purpose in our hearts. You know, we say, God, you promised me that, you know, it's not even a promise, it's a fact already. By His stripes, I'm healed. Amen. That's all God wants from you.